Hello everybody. Welcome to IMS Ghaziabad University Courses Campus Flip Classes. I'm Anuradha Bhardwaj and today we will be discussing about emotional intelligence. Have you ever given it a thought? It's usually seen that people who do not score marvelous grades and possess average intelligence, they outperform those who have high levels of intelligence. You must have heard of Abraham Lincoln, who was the 16th President of the United States. You must have also heard about Britney Spears, the best-selling female artist of the first decade of 21st century. They had low IQ, and we all know where they stand in terms of success. So it's not only IQ, there is something called soft skills or emotional intelligence, which plays its role beautifully. Now let's have a look at this slide. This shows the difference between IQ and EQ. When we talk about the intelligence quotient, let me tell you one thing, that IQ of a person remains stable throughout the life. We cannot work on somebody's IQ. But when we talk about EQ, EQ is flexible and we can work on somebody's EQ. You can work on your EQ, right? So one can work on their EQs and see the wonders and achieve the unachievable. So before delving into the concept of emotional intelligence, let's first see what emotions are. Emotion basically is a mental state or a strong feeling derived from one's circumstances, from one's mood, relationships one is into, the environment one gets during the growing years, your origin, and many more things. Emotions are involved in everything people do, we do. Any action we do, any decision we take, any judgment we pass. Now think of an incident when you scolded somebody. What emotions you had within you? Anger? Yes. Now what emotions you had in you when you organized a surprise birthday party for your friend? Excitement, right? Now all of us would agree to one thing here, that there will be a difference in the outcome of our decisions, actions and judgment when we are upset and when we are not upset. If we are in control of our emotions, obviously we will be constructive, we can contribute to enhance our performance, and we can contribute to better decision making. So one thing is clear from here, that emotions play a very major role in our lives, both personally as well as professionally. So now, what is emotional intelligence? Using the emotions intelligently is what emotional intelligence talks about. Now, this is one of the quotes which I really admire and like, which is given by Aristotle. He says that anybody can become angry, that is easy. But to be angry with the right person, to the right degree, at the right time, for the right purpose and in the right way is not easy. So what matters is how you handle your emotions and use it for your good. Now technically, if we talk about the concept of emotional intelligence, EI consists of five factors: well-being, self-control, emotionality, sociability and independence. Well-being of a person tells that how happy, optimistic he is and what is his self-esteem. If he's happy-go-lucky person, or if he's a gloomy one, or he's able to strike a balance between the two, neither he's too happy nor he's too sad. Then if he's optimistic or pessimistic, his self-esteem is high or average, right? Next is self-control. Self-control tells that if a person can regulate his or her emotions, manage the stress levels, and control his impulses. Emotionality factor tells the level of empathy, relationships, the emotion perception a person has, and the emotion expression of a person. Sociability tells us if a person is socially aware, if he's assertive and can manage others' emotions, Independence tells if he's adaptable to changing environment and if he's self-motivated or not. Now, the question is that what is the use of emotional intelligence at workplace? Now, let me tell you one thing, that many organizations get the EI tests done to know the candidate before hiring them. For instance, if you are selected for a job which demands you to be high on stress management, say financial manager, then your self-control factor can clearly tell if you are fit for the job or should the employer drop you. All these processes are undertaken before selecting the final candidate. Basically, the reason behind this is the employer want to avoid the extra cost afterwards on training and hiring a person, and then the retrenchment if the decision made is not correct. Okay? Now, let me take another example. Imagine that you are the employer and you've shortlisted few candidates for the profile which demands them to communicate with the clients across the world, right? So you will be interested in hiring that candidate who's adaptable and whose sociability score is good, right? Now, not only this, EI score also helps the employer to decide the domain in which the employer can put the candidate or the employee, right? If the sociability factor of somebody is really very good, that person can be directly put in dealing with the, you know, the high profile clients. Now, let's have a look at the characteristics of people having low IQ, sorry, EQ, and high EQ. The person who will be having low EI will not be contented with his life. He or she will be having a pessimistic attitude. They'll be less empathetic. They'll be less socially aware. And they'll be less adaptable to changes. On the other hand, if we look at the characteristics of a person with high EI, they'll be contented. They'll have an optimistic approach towards life. They'll be empathetic in the right way, to the right degree. They'll be socially aware and they'll be adaptable as well. Let's see, what are the advantages of emotional intelligence? Why one should have emotional intelligence? First thing, it improves the relationship. Like, you know that you're working somewhere, so you need to build relationship there. If your relationship is healthy, you'll be able to do good at your workplace. Not only at workplace, at personal front also, you need to have good relationships. So EI will help you to build healthy relationships around you. It helps you to improve communication with people. It will help you to manage change more confidently. It will help you to get better empathetic skills. It will help you to act with integrity. It will help you to feel confident and positive. You will enjoy your work wholeheartedly. You'll be ready to learn from your mistakes. You'll be receptive. You'll increase your creativity levels and your stress levels will be reduced. Now, this is one of the most important questions. Can we work on EI? You remember, we discussed the difference between IQ and EQ, where we talked about that IQ is stable and it cannot change throughout the life of a person. On the contrary, EQ is flexible and we can work on EQ, right? So yes, we can work on our EQ. So let's see, how can we work on our EQs? Let's go stepwise. The first step says that we should be analyzing ourselves. We need to identify first where we need to improve. Second, start observing the people around you who are good at that area where you need improvement. Because, you know, we are more of passive learners than being the active learners. 60% of the population is passive learner population. Then try to find out the deviation or the gap in your approach and their approach. Finally, you can take the corrective actions, what you should do and what you should not do. Let's have a look at the do's for improving EI. When you are in the process of improving your EI, these are the do's. Make introspection a regular routine. Ask for others' perspective because they'll be able to give you a better picture of yourself and your growth graph. Listen more and speak less. You should be observant. You should be curious, but not furious. If you want others to trust you, you should trust them first. And then practice, practice, and practice all of these. The don'ts for improving EI: stop complaining first. And do not be pessimistic, do not be negative at all. Don't be so critical about yourself and about others. Stop thinking about your past all the time. Be futuristic. You should not be selfish. Peer pressure should not affect you negatively. And stop procrastinating the things. Now, I want to conclude this flip class with this beautiful thought. It's often said that people are hired for their skills and fired for their behavior, which is so true. You might get through the technical round in the interview. You might clear the personal interview as well. But later, if the organization finds you unfit for the position, you might be fired. Right? So start working on your emotional intelligence. All the best. Thank you.